Expand your vocabulary with our Core 2000 Words ebook. It's free and packed with essential expressions that you'll use on a daily basis. Start building your vocabulary today. Click the link in the description below to download your free Hindi ebook before it's gone.
Namaste. HindiPod101.com में स्वागत है.
Namaste. मेरा नाम प्रेरणा है. Hi everybody. My name is Prerna. Welcome to HindiPod101.com's Hindi in 3 minutes. The fastest, easiest and most fun way to learn Hindi. In the last lesson, we learned how to show gratitude to people by saying Dhanyavad. In this lesson, we'll learn some of the most common greetings used in India. Kya aap tayar hain? Are you ready? To chaliye, shuru kare. So, let's begin. Let's start with a greeting you're sure to have heard before. Namaste. This is a word that is so closely associated with India and Indian culture that it has become famous all over the world. Namaste. Namaste. The word namaste is made out of two Sanskrit words, nama and te, which have been joined to mean I salute you. We use namaste as a formal as well as a friendly greeting. It's used when people meet at any time of the day, morning, noon or evening. A slightly more formal variation on namaste, which you may or may not have heard before, is namaskar. Namaskar. Use this and you'll surely impress your Indian friends. In Hindi, using different greetings for each time of the day is not very common. When talking with friends, we usually just use the English phrases. But there are equivalent Hindi versions. They're just not used that often. If you meet someone before noon, you can say Suprabhat. Suprabhat. For later in the day, you can say Shubh Sandhya. Shubh Sandhya. But for most of the time, you can just say Namaste and not worry about it. As we learn in this lesson, Namaste can mean both hello and goodbye. However, this is not the only way of saying goodbye in Hindi. A parting expression that we can use for all occasions is Fir Milenge, which means see you. Fir Milenge. Fir Milenge. The first word Fir means again and the second word Milenge means we will meet. Let's look at one more expression. Alvida. Alvida is an Urdu word which means goodbye. Alvida. It is an appropriate choice when parting for a long time. Now, it's time for Prerna's points. The easiest way of saying your goodbyes in Hindi is by using Namaste. Take a slight bow with folded hands and say Namaste. Namaste and Namaskar both come from Sanskrit and mean something like I honor you or I bow to you. In the next lesson, we'll learn the meaning of the phrase Kya aap Angrezi bolte hain? Do you already know it? We'll be waiting to talk about it with you in our next Hindi in 3 Minutes lesson. Phir milenge.
You probably already have language learning goals, but the real key to success is to make the right goals. In this video, I'll show you how, with 5 tips to stop wasting your time and start learning. Hi everyone, Alicia here. In this video, I'll teach you 5 tips to stop procrastinating and keep your motivation for learning a new language. Some of these are study methods, and some will be general ways that you can keep your study motivation up. While these tips are for studying a language, some of them are good for other things in your life too, such as new challenges or other types of goals. But before we start, don't forget to click the link in the description to get your bundle of PDF cheat sheets, including survival phrases, romantic lines, learning tips, absolutely free. Now, you probably already have some goals you're trying to achieve when it comes to your language learning progress. While achieving these goals is important, making sure you make the right goals is the real key to success. The very first tip is to set SMART goals. SMART is an acronym, meaning each letter in the word stands for another word. The earliest known reference to SMART goals was in an article written by George T. Doran for a 1981 issue of the Management Review Academic Journal. The acronym varies depending on its use, but each letter generally stands for some criterion that helps with effective goal setting. For our purposes, let's define SMART goals as follows. The S stands for specific. Your goals should target a specific area for improvement. Our natural tendency is to have a goal that's very general. If your goal isn't specific enough, you'll lack the focus and proper direction you need to achieve your goals. So S is for specific. M stands for measurable. Your goals should be quantifiable. They should be able to indicate progress in some way. You have to be able to track your progress, otherwise you won't know if you're getting any closer to your goal. As you see yourself getting closer and closer to your goal, your motivation will go up. So your goals need to be measurable. A stands for achievable. Your goals have to be achievable. Many people want to become fluent in their target language immediately. However, this goal is unrealistic. Your goals have to be achievable. If your goal is too challenging for your current level, it will only demotivate you when you aren't where you think you should be. Instead, think about what results can realistically be achieved given your level, your resources, and any constraints, such as time. So make sure that your goal is actually achievable. R stands for relevant. Your goals may be specific, they may be measurable, and they may be achievable, but are they actually relevant to what you want to achieve? Don't just do a lot of things. If you're focused on improving your speaking skills in your target language, make sure that you spend your time having conversations with others. Make sure you're doing the right things so that your efforts actually bring you closer to your goal instead of just giving you more work. T stands for timely. You need to set a deadline for your goals. If you don't specify when you plan to achieve the result you've set for yourself, it's very easy to put off the task. You can delay it until tomorrow, the next week, or the next month, and at this rate, you'll never get things done. So your goal must have an end date. So remember, tip number one is to set SMART goals: specific, measurable, achievable, relevant, and timely. So, for example, a goal you could make is registering for a challenging test, a test that's a little bit beyond your current level. I hate failing, so if I register for a challenging test, I'm motivated to study because I don't want to fail. This is a good example of a SMART goal because tests are specific. There are tons of different tests focused on speaking, grammar, and comprehension. Pick a test that can measure the specific area in which you'd like to grow. Measurable. Tests are measurable. Every test measures your performance to some degree. Whether it's a total count of right and wrong answers or a simple pass or fail, every test measures your performance. Tests are achievable. There's an important detail to remember here, though. Find a test that is achievable for you. If you're a beginner, then the most advanced test is probably not right for you. Find one that's meant for beginners. Then, after that one, work your way up to more advanced tests in the future. Tests are relevant. Most, if not all, language tests are designed to ensure that you're capable of performing to a set standard in your target language. Lower level tests are designed to ensure that you can handle the most essential aspects of your target language. But there are tests for all levels, including higher education entry exams that could be difficult, even for native speakers. Pick the one that's right for you. And finally, tests are timely. If your test is completed in a physical location, then this one is obvious. You have to be at that spot at the set time, ready to take the test. There's no wiggle room. But even online tests will most likely have a deadline for you to complete them. The second tip to help you stop procrastinating and to keep your motivation up is to create a diary or social media account that you can update every day. This may seem simple or even unrelated to language learning, but by creating a diary in your target language, you have the chance to actually create in the language itself. Creating a diary is also a great way to practice writing in your target language. Another method is to create a social media account, which gives you the chance to connect with other people who are working toward the same goals as you. Maybe they can even give you feedback on your writing. If you're following people online who regularly share good resources, those can be really helpful for you too. It lets you find new tools that can encourage and motivate you, especially if they relate to some of your other interests, such as music or books in other languages. This is a really good way to take a few minutes every day to work towards your goal, without it even seeming like work. The third tip is to focus on understanding a specific TV show or movie. Try to watch a movie in your target language without any subtitles, or try to understand your favorite TV show that's in your target language. If you don't already have a goal like this, it can be a fun way to practice. If your friends often talk about a particular TV show, it could be a good way to study and a fun way to keep your motivation up together. Plus, TV shows and movies often use the language in a way that's vastly different from the conversations provided in traditional textbooks. So you often get to hear different vocabulary choices. It's a very powerful way to learn a language and end up sounding more like a native speaker. Tip number four is to enroll in a regular language course. Register for something you have to go to or you have to participate in regularly, meaning every week or two times a week or maybe even every day. The point of this is it's something that gives you a pattern to follow. Forming a study habit will help you progress very quickly. It will make it easier for you to achieve your language learning goals. Once you form the habit, you won't even have to think about starting each time. It'll just be natural. Have something that you must take responsibility for. You'll be more motivated to continue if there are others, especially classmates or a teacher, watching you progress. Look for resources inside your community. And if there are no opportunities there, look for things digitally. You can find many of our videos on YouTube, on Facebook, and of course, our entire video and audio lesson library on our website. The lessons on our website also come with assignment courses, so you can test your knowledge. The last tip is to make your goal public. Share your goal. Tell people about your goal. For example, if you want to give a business presentation in your target language this year, then tell your colleagues or your boss about it. Some people may find what you're doing interesting, and they can support you. This kind of pressure can help push people forward who have trouble motivating themselves alone. By telling others about your goal, you feel more accountable. Because you told somebody that you were planning on doing something, there's an underlying sense of guilt if you don't accomplish the task. You may feel that you have failed your peers in some way, even if there's no direct pressure from them. Using this technique, you can push yourself into moving forward toward your goal, especially at times when you feel the least motivated. And that brings us to the end of our 5 tips to stop wasting time and start learning a language. We've talked a lot about how to set goals for yourself and think about new challenges. First, I told you about creating SMART goals. Remember, SMART goals are specific, measurable, achievable, relevant, and timely. Registering for a test is a great example of a SMART goal. Next, we talked about keeping a diary or social media account in your target language. Start doing it right now, even if you're still a beginner. Then, I suggested that you focus on understanding a specific TV show or movie. Pick something in your target language that you really love, because you may need to watch it over and over again until it all makes sense to you. And next, we talked about enrolling in a regular language course. This will give you something concrete that you must take responsibility for. Finally, make your goal public. Tell someone about your learning goals to keep you accountable for them. You're much less likely to abandon your studies if you have friends asking you about your progress. I hope that these are useful tips that you can use to reach your language learning goals. And before we go, let me remind you to download tons of free PDF lessons to learn the language the fast, fun, and easy way. Just click the link in the description. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up and share it with anyone who may find it useful. Do you have any good tips that you've used to help you reach your goals? Share them in the comments. Thanks very much for watching, and see you next time.
Hi, welcome to Introduction to Hindi. My name is Alicia, and I'm joined by...
Hi everyone, I'm Venus.
In this lesson, you'll learn the basics of Hindi pronunciation.
Just like English, Hindi also has consonants and vowels.
Hindi has 33 main consonants and 11 vowels. If you learn the sounds of these consonants and vowels, you'll be able to pronounce every single word in Hindi.
There are also two additional consonants and two additional vowels, as well as few conjuncts, but you don't have to worry about them right now.
Yes, because once you're comfortable with the 33 main consonants and the 11 vowels, the rest will come pretty easily.
It may seem like a difficult task, but actually you already know many of these sounds in English.
So, how about we first take a look at some of the consonants in Hindi?
Yes, let's begin with some unaspirated consonants along with their aspirated counterparts.
We won't be working on the consonants in the order they occur in the Hindi alphabet system, simply because some of them are more commonly used than others. We'll take a look at these in order when we get to the lesson on writing.
Hindi consonants are known as vyanjan.
Yes, you're already familiar with many of them because the sounds already exist in English or are quite similar to certain sounds in English.
For example, the first consonant in Hindi is K, which is similar to the English letter K.
But the next one doesn't exist in English.
Yes, this one is K. When you say it without aspiration, you get K. But when you say it with aspiration, it becomes K.
Interesting. But let me first explain what aspirated and unaspirated sounds are. In very simple words, we can say that aspirated sounds are spoken with a burst of air, and an unaspirated sound isn't.
For example, the sound of the letter H in the English word hat. Saying this sound involves a forceful expulsion of air. Try it yourself. Ha.
Ha.
In Hindi, when you say K, there is no forceful expulsion of air. But when you say K, you will feel yourself expelling the air from your mouth. Try it yourself and see the difference. K, K. Next, let's take a look at G, which is the same as the sound of the letter G in the English word game. Yes, when you say G without aspiration, you get G. But when you say it with aspiration, you get gh.
Yes, that's the next consonant. It works the same way for some other consonants too.
Yes, like ch is the same as the ch in the English word chain, without aspiration. When you say ch with aspiration, it becomes ch. Similarly, we have j and j, t and th, d and dh, t and th, d and dh, p and p, b and bh.
But what about the other consonants?
Definitely, that doesn't complete our list of consonant sounds. Now, let's take a look at some of the other consonants and how they sound. Let's first take a look at the consonant h. It sounds like the letter H in the English word hug. We also have y, which is like the sound of the letter Y in the English word yak.
There are two letters that sound like the SH in the English word share.
Yes, these are sh and sh. They sound the same when spoken. We will use the small letter S to denote them both from now on. We also have a sound that is similar to the English letter S, like in the word sun. This is sir. This one is sir, and we will use the capital S from now on when we refer to it.
Okay, what's next?
We also have n. N is just the sound of the English letter N. R is the same as the sound of the letter R in rat. L is the same as the sound of the letter L in lamb. M is the same as the sound of the letter M in Mars. V is the same as the sound of the letter W in work.
Are there any other consonants in Hindi that we haven't discussed?
We also have N.
This may seem to be a difficult sound, as it doesn't exist in English.
Just try saying N, but roll back your tongue slightly. N.
But aren't we still missing two consonants?
Yes, we are. We also have N and N. But we don't have to worry much about them, since they aren't used alone ever.
So, now that we've taken a look at the consonants, how about we take a quick look at the vowels, too?
The Hindi vowels are known as swar.
There are 11 main vowels in Hindi, and most of them are the same as in English.
For example, A is like the sound of the letter A in the English word apply. A is like the sound of the letter A in the word father. E is like the letter I in tin. E is like the letters E, E in C. Then we have U, which is like the letter U in put. And U is like the sound of the letters O, O in room. A is like the A in May. A is like the sound of the letter A in hat. We also have O and O. O sounds like the O in box. And O sounds like the letters A, W in sa. We also have another vowel, which is ri, something like the R, I in riddle. We actually learned a word in the last lesson which uses ri, kripya, which means please.
Indeed. So, how are vowels used in Hindi?
Hindi vowels can be used alone or in the form of a matra or vowel signs where it modifies a consonant. A good example where both the forms can be used in a single word is the Hindi word achha, meaning good or okay. Achha. A. The first letter A is a standalone form of the vowel A. Cha. But if you see the matra at the end, after the letter Ch, the vowel A here is modifying the consonant Ch. This means that the sound now becomes Ch plus A, Cha. Let's see how the vowels modify the consonant K. It can become Ka, Ki, Ki, Ku, Ku, Ke, Ke, Ko, Ko.
That's a lot that we learned about the sounds in Hindi.
It may seem as too much to learn in the beginning, but as you continue to practice, things will get easier.
True. The best thing to do is practice, practice, and practice. In this lesson, we learned that in Hindi there are 33 consonants and 11 vowels.
Consonants are called vyanjan in Hindi, and vowels are called swar.
The vowels have a standalone version, and when they're attached to a consonant, they modify its sound.
So, in the word achha, the first A is a standalone form of the vowel A, but the last vowel A appears in the form of a modifier and turns CH into CHA.
Among the consonants, we realize that there are forms that are already present in English. When we say these consonants without aspiration, we get one consonant. When we say them with aspiration, we get another consonant, which generally doesn't exist in English.
For example, K is a consonant, and when we say it with aspiration, it becomes another consonant, K.
We just learned the basics of pronunciation in Hindi in this lesson, and in the next lesson, we'll learn the basics of Hindi grammar. See you in the next lesson. Bye!
Dhanyavaad and namaste.
Want to finally learn Hindi the fast, fun, and easy way? In this video, I'll show you the top 10 ways to get started. So let's begin. Number 1, take your very first lesson. Access any audio or video lesson on HindiPod101.com and just press the play button to get started. Don't have an account? Don't worry. Just go to the sign up page to create an account. It takes less than 30 seconds and it's free. We have thousands of audio and video lessons covering a variety of topics like grammar, pronunciation, listening, and reading. Just click on the play button on any lesson and start learning. Number two, read along with the lesson. You can read along with the lesson notes or lesson transcript. These come with every lesson. The lesson notes provide you with the dialogue for the scene taught in the lesson, along with translations, a more in-depth explanation of the grammar and culture, and even vocab and sample sentences. The lesson transcript is the full word-for-word transcript of everything you hear in the lesson. And the dialogue study tool provides you with the audio for the lesson dialogue, along with the translations. Number three, shadowing. Shadowing is a tested learning technique where you repeat what you hear. This is a great way to start speaking in minutes and practice speaking in general. If you're listening along with the lesson audio or dialogue, be sure to shadow along the way. Number four, use the dialogue study tool to master the conversation. Here, you get the line-by-line breakdown of the conversation demonstrated in the lesson. Listen and repeat until you've mastered each line. Do this until you've mastered the entire conversation. Number five, use the voice recorder to perfect your pronunciation and speaking. In the dialogue study tool, you'll find a microphone icon next to each line. Click on it to record your voice. Then, compare it with the native speakers. Listen and adjust your pronunciation until you match that of the native speaker. Number six, review vocab with the lesson vocabulary list. Vocabulary words are the building blocks of language. You can save vocab words taught in each lesson by clicking on Add to Word Bank. Want to drill the words with smart flashcards instead? Just click on Add to Flashcard Deck to do so. Number seven, listen to the review track. If you've studied an audio lesson before, just listen to the review track so that you don't have to listen through the entire lesson again. This is a great way to reinforce the material that you've learned, and it's great to have on the go. Just access any audio lesson and click on the download icon. Then click Review to download the review track. Number eight, review with quizzes after the lesson. Once you're confident enough with the material taught in the lesson, be sure to take the quiz to test your newfound knowledge. Take the review questions and answer true or false for each one. Or take the writing questions and input your answer. Remember to check the answers by clicking on the Check Answers button. Number nine, participate and leave a comment. The best way to master what you've learned is to use it. Join the community of learners by leaving a comment below at the end of every lesson. Our dedicated teachers will check your responses to correct you on any mistakes or provide you with helpful study tips and advice. And finally, number 10, move on to the next lesson. Done with a lesson? Mark the lesson as complete. You can see your overall learning progress on your dashboard. If you particularly enjoyed the lesson, mark the lesson as favorite so that you can come back to it later at any time. Click on the forward arrow to move on to the next lesson and continue learning. If you enjoyed these tips, hit the like button, share it with anyone who's trying to learn Hindi, and subscribe to our channel. We release new videos every week. Remember, you can sign up to HindiPod101.com by clicking on the link in the description. Sign up takes less than 30 seconds, and it's free. I'll see you next time. Bye!
Namaste, welcome to HindiPod101.com, the easiest, quickest and smartest way to learn Hindi online. My name is Anuj Khurana and today we are going to discuss 25 verbs in Hindi. So let's begin.
Hona, to be.
So first verb is hona, which means to be. Aap kahan par ho? Where are you?
Ke paas hona? To have.
Our next verb is ke paas hona. Aapke paas hona, which means to have. Mere paas ek kutta hai. I have a pet dog.
Karna, to do.
Our next verb is karna, which means to do. Chalo milke jogging karte hai. Come on, let's do jogging together.
Bolna, to say.
Our next verb is bolna, which means to say. Rahul ne kya bola? What did Rahul say?
Samjhana, to explain.
Samjhana, which means to explain. Kya aapne apne dada ji ko samjhaya? Did you explain it to your grandfather?
Sunna, to hear.
Our next verb is sunna, which means to hear. Kya aapne wo awaaz suni? Did you hear that sound?
Jana, to go.
Our next verb is jana. Jana, which means to go. Suman school jayegi. Suman will go to school.
Janna, to know.
Okay, so moving on, our next verb is janna. Janna, which means to know. Kya aap French jante hain? Do you know French?
Lena, to take.
Lena, which means to take. Nitika apne saath apne kutte ko lekar gayi. Nitika has taken her dog along with her.
Dekhna, to see.
Next verb is dekhna, which means to see. Rohan ek film dekhne gaya hai. Rohan has gone to watch a movie.
Aana, to come.
Okay, so our next verb is aana, which means to come. Aaj Mahima aayengi. Today, Mahima will come.
Sochna, to think.
Our next verb is sochna, which means to think. Main aapko sochkar batata hoon. Let me think and I'll get back to you.
Dekhna, to look.
Our next word is dekhna, which means to see. Yahan se sara shahar dikhai deta hai. We can see the whole city from here.
Chahna, to want.
Next verb is chahna, to want. Aap kya lena chahenge? What would you like to have?
Dena, to give.
Dena. Dena, which means to give. Mujhe wo file de dijiye. Please hand over that file to me. Or please give that file to me.
Istemal karna, to use.
Our next verb is istemal karna, which means to use. Meri dadi ko computer istemal karna aata hai. My grandmother knows how to use computer.
Dhoondna, to find.
Next verb is dhoondna, to find. Manav apna phone dhoond raha hai. Manav is looking for his phone.
Batana, to tell.
Batana, which means to tell. Mujhe wo kahani dobara se batana. Please tell me that story again.
Poochna, to ask.
Poochna, poochna, which means to ask. Mujhe aapse kuch poochna hai. I want to ask you something.
Kaam karna, to work.
Our next verb is kaam karna, which means to work. Ram kaam kar raha hai. Ram is working.
Lagna, to seem.
Lagna, to seem. Diwaron par ye rang kafi goora lag raha hai. This color seems to be very dark on the walls. So we are going to discuss the same word again because it can be taken in different context also. So lagna can be taken as are you feeling it? Lagna is the Hindi verb which can be taken as to feel. Kya aapko garmi lag rahi hai? Are you feeling hot here? So lagna can be taken in two different ways.
Koshish karna, to try.
Koshish karna, which means टू ट्राई, मैं पढ़ाई करने की कोशिश कर रहा हूं. आई एम ट्राइंग टू स्टडी.
निकलना, टू लीव.
Our next verb is निकलना, which means to leave. वो अभी घर से निकला है. He has just left from home.
बुलाना, to call out.
Our next verb is बुलाना, which means to call out. तुम्हारी मम्मी तुम्हें बुला रही है. Your mom is calling out for you.
समझना, to understand.
So next verb is samajhna, to understand. Mujhe Farsi samajh nahi aati. I do not understand Farsi. So that's all from today's lesson. So these were the verbs which are most commonly used in Hindi, and they're gonna help you a lot to understand others, what they are saying. I hope you have enjoyed our video, and if you did so, please click on the like button, and you can also subscribe to our channel, which is hindipod101.com. If there's any kind of feedback or any comments you want to leave, you can just write them down in the comments section. I will be back with more videos. Till then, you can also visit to our website, which is www.hindipod101.com. Stay tuned. I'll be back with more videos. Till then, goodbye. Take care. Namaste, welcome to HindiPod101.com, the easiest, smartest and the quickest way to learn Hindi online. My name is Anuj Khurana and I'm back with yet another Hindi lesson with new Hindi words. Today we are going to discuss about 10 phrases, 10 sentences which you can use to amaze a native speaker. So let's begin. Dhanyavaad, lekin main vastav mein ek deshi vakta nahi hoon. Thank you, but actually I am not a native speaker. धन्यवाद लेकिन मैं वास्तव में एक देशी वक्ता नहीं हूं. Thank you, but actually I'm not a native speaker. मैं 10 सालों से हिंदी सीख रहा हूँ. I've been learning Hindi for 10 years now. मैं 10 सालों से हिंदी सीख रहा हूँ. I've been learning Hindi for 10 years now. मैं 3 सालों में एक देशी वक्ता की तरह हिंदी बोल पाऊंगा. I'll be able to speak Hindi like a native speaker in 3 years. मैं 3 सालों में एक देशी वक्ता की तरह हिंदी बोल पाऊंगा. I'll be able to speak Hindi like a native speaker in 3 years. Well, that's quite a good speed if you can speak like a native speaker in 3 years. Nothing like that. मैं खुद से ही हिंदी सीख रहा हूँ. I'm learning Hindi by my own. मैं खुद से ही हिंदी सीख रहा हूँ. I'm learning Hindi by my own. Well, you have HindiPod101.com. You can learn Hindi quite quickly from there too. मैं उपशीर्षकों के बिना भी एक हिंदी फिल्म देख सकता हूँ. I can watch a Hindi film without the subtitles. मैं उपशीर्षकों के बिना भी एक हिंदी फिल्म देख सकता हूँ. I can watch a Hindi film without the subtitles. But I'm sure you all must be aware of Bollywood. These films are a lot of drama, a lot of romance, and if you're good at Hindi, you can enjoy Bollywood films. आपने जो कहा मैं पूरा समझ गया हूँ. I've understood everything you have said. आपने जो कहा मैं पूरा समझ गया हूँ. I've understood everything you have said. मैं लगभग 50 नए हिंदी के शब्द एक दिन में याद कर सकता हूँ. I can learn 50 new Hindi words in a day. मैं लगभग 50 नए हिंदी के शब्द एक दिन में याद कर सकता हूँ. I can learn 50 new Hindi words in a day. Well, trust me, if you can do so, you can quickly become a fluent Hindi speaker. हिंदी के अलावा मैं और भी कई भाषाओं में बात कर सकता हूँ. I can speak several other languages apart from Hindi. हिंदी के अलावा मैं और भी कई भाषाओं में बात कर सकता हूँ. I can speak several other languages apart from Hindi. Well, if you can do so, trust me, you are very talented because I can just speak Hindi and English. मैं खुद हिंदी पढ़ और लिख सकता हूँ. I can write and read Hindi on my own. Our next sentence is, मैं खुद हिंदी पढ़ और लिख सकता हूँ. I can write and read Hindi on my own. मैं कभी कभी हिंदी कविता लिखता हूँ. At times I write Hindi poems. Well, if you're doing that, it's just amazing. If you're learning a language and writing poems and that, nothing better than that. मैं कभी कभी हिंदी कविता लिखता हूँ. At times I write Hindi poems. Well, that's all from today's lesson. I hope you enjoyed a video lesson. If you have any kind of suggestions, any kind of feedback, you can write them in the comment section. And if you liked the video, please click on the like button. You can also subscribe to our channel, which is HindiPod 101. For more such kind of Hindi lessons, you can visit our website, which is www.hindipod101.com. I'll be back with more Hindi lessons. Till then, stay tuned. Goodbye.
Expand your vocabulary with our Core 2000 Words ebook. It's free and packed with essential expressions that you'll use on a daily basis. Start building your vocabulary today. Click the link in the description below to download your free Hindi ebook before it's gone.